Welcome to Fulton. We want to show you around a little bit about some things of new expectations for hallways, bathrooms, cafeteria, library, those kinds of things. So we're going to take a quick tour to show you sort of what our expectations are, and I want you to follow me as we walk around the building. One of the things you'll notice as you walk around the building are some stairwells only go up, some stairwells only go down. The stairwells here in the main lobby, they do both. So if you will stay to the right over here as you go up and come down on the other side over here, we will control the traffic of students coming in and out from fourth floor to third and third floor to second, and that will help us out a lot. This is the mid-floor stairwell on the third floor, and it will go all the way up to the fourth floor. It goes all the way down to the first floor. You'll notice the signs in this stairwell mean that this stairwell is down only. So if you're on the third floor and you need to go to the second or first floor, this is a stairwell you will go to, not the T. If you're on the fourth floor, this is the stairwell you'll go to get to the first floor. So down only, please follow the signs. This is the stairwell known as the T because it meets up where all the classes split at the end of the hallway on the second and third floor. And on the first floor. So you'll notice here that all of the arrows point up. So you can only go up on the T stairwell. Again, do not congregate outside the T, do not congregate in the hallways, but if you're moving from one floor to the other and you need to go up, the T stairwell is up only this year. As you're walking up and down the hallways, we're gonna ask that you stay to the right-hand side of the hallway, and you'll notice on the floor as you're walking, there'll be some arrows to remind you that the right-hand side goes one direction and the left-hand side of the hallway goes the other direction. There are also signs on the floor to remind you to socially distance, so we would ask that you not walk in big clumps of kids. The other thing to remember about the hallways this year is there will be no standing around by the lockers congregating and talking for 2 or 3 minutes. Those days are over during COVID-19. When you are dismissed from class, or you're dismissed from breakfast to go to class, or you're dismissed from lunch to go to class, you go directly to class. Do not pass go, do not collect $200. You do not stand in the hallway, you do not spend time congregating. We want socially distanced passage, we want everybody going the direction of the arrows, and we want you to wear your masks. Bathrooms, during classroom breaks, we will have somebody outside all of the bathrooms to limit it to 2 people in each restroom before you go to your class change. If you are in class and you need a restroom pass, you will be given a paper pass from your teacher. We are not using the yellow plastic passes this year. You get a paper pass and it will be color-coded by the floor you're on, and it is your responsibility to go to the bathroom only on the floor you're on with that colored pass. As you come into the building this year, you will see that there are limited access points into the building. Everybody who enters the building will have their temperature checked, you will be made sure that you have your mask on, and you need to be in dress code before you come to school. I know this is different, and it's not what everybody's used to, but you need to be in dress code when you come in the door, and the reason for that is simple, because we want to be able to immediately tell where you need to go in the morning. So if you are a ninth grader, you will immediately go to the library or the auditorium balcony. If you are a 10th grader, you will not be allowed in this building in the morning. You will report directly to the gym up at the top of the hill. We've arranged for the buses to drop you off up there, so stay on the bus until you get dropped off. And if you're a car rider, be sure and tell your parents that you need to be dropped off at the gym. If you are in Skill Pro, you will come to the cafeteria and you will spend your time before school in the cafeteria. If you are in full comm or health science, you will go immediately to the auditorium. We will have you sitting on opposite sides of the auditorium by your SLC. It is possible for you to get breakfast in the morning, and so we will have 2 or 3 places for you to pick up a grab-and-go breakfast. There's no more walking through the lines in the cafeteria, and you will get breakfast and you will immediately go to your assigned spot to wait until the bell rings at 8:15. So be in dress code when you get to school. Wear your mask when you come to the door, get your temperature checked.